Hello. In this video, we will understand the basic difference between competitive antagonist and non-competitive antagonist. Let's get started. In video on receptors and ligands, we have seen that receptors are like taps that we see at public places. They are active only as long as the button is kept pressed. As the button is released, they close. We people are like agonists. We press the button and tap opens. When we leave it, it closes. So we are agonists. Now antagonists. They basically prevent the action of agonist. They can be of two types, competitive antagonist and non-competitive antagonist. The caterpillar is like competitive antagonist. When we say competitive, the competition is for the button. Whoever is at the high concentration will occupy the button. If caterpillars are high in number, they will occupy the button. But they are not strong enough to press the button, and they also prevent the agonist from opening the tap. As a result, the tap stays closed. However, if concentration of agonist is increased, they can displace the antagonist and activate the tap. Thus, the agonist and competitive antagonist compete for the same binding site, and whoever is at higher concentration dominates. Now the non-competitive antagonist. It's like this wedge. It takes such a position that prevents the button from getting pressed. No amount of agonist can open the tap once non-competitive antagonist has taken its position. You see, they don't compete with agonist for same binding site. They bind with a different site. And that's why they are called non-competitive antagonist. So this is the basic difference between competitive and non-competitive antagonist. Now let's see examples. For mu opioid receptors, morphine is agonist and naloxone is competitive antagonist. They both compete with each other for binding with the receptor. When naloxone concentration is high, it occupies the receptor and prevents the action of morphine. If morphine concentration is increased, it displaces naloxone and activates the receptor. Now the example for non-competitive antagonism. For NMDA receptor, glutamate is agonist and ketamine is non-competitive antagonist. If ketamine has blocked the receptor, no concentration of glutamate can activate the receptor. I hope you now understand the difference between competitive and non-competitive antagonism. In summary, competitive antagonist competes with agonist for same binding site. Its effect can be surmounted by increasing agonist concentration. Non-competitive antagonist, on the other hand, binds to a different site, and its effect cannot be surmounted by increasing agonist concentration. That's it for this video. If you feel this video will help your friends and colleagues, share it with them too. And don't forget to subscribe because lots more to come. At Nonstop Neuron, learning medical concepts is as easy as watching cartoons. Thanks for watching. See you in next video.